community, and then high power delegation of the CPC. The directors of APC are present, director of administration, director of director of director of media, and every other delegated. I am greatly enthused to be part of this meeting with the team, building a community with a shared future for mankind. The ruling party's mission and contribution. We are aware that the 6th plenary session of the 19th Committee of the Community of China just ended very well. And the APC is going to show comradeship with a view to deepening the relationship that exists between our two great political partners, the Communist Party of China and the All Progressive Party of Nigeria. Political parties are by far the most important ingredient of participatory democracy and should therefore play a vital role in fostering a world of peace. Interconnectivity, global trade and development. Today, technology has created avenues for people to fit into digital communities with which they are mentally connected. This has also brought a greater interaction among communities and government, and the exchange of ideas, beliefs, and culture across distant localities. The Communist Party of China shares a lot of similarity with the APC. From a membership of less than 100% in 1921 to more than 92 million today. The CPC has led the people of China from poverty to prosperity over the past 100 years. The APC has just been around for less than a decade, and we are talking of a membership of over 20 million persons. The CPC-led government of China has fully implemented the 5 spheres integrated plan for promotion, economic, political, cultural, social, and ecological progress, and coordinated progress of the 4-pronged comprehensive strategy to build a modern, prosperous society. The APC and the PC have a lot in common. For example, serving the people wholeheartedly. The APC-led government of President Muhammad Buhari is very sincere in his approach to government. His empathy towards the people has been the largest social investment program ever witnessed in this part of the globe. For instance, the COVID-19 loans targeted at SMEs that were hit by the pandemic. The Empower scheme targeted at persons below 35 years at 30,000 naira each, and about 2 million of Nigerians have benefited thus far. The conditional cash transfer to the poorest of the poor is also on board. The school feeding program, which has tripled the enrollment of school children. The Ample Borrower scheme targeted at helping farmers in sustainable agricultural production. Agricultural production. The abundance encapsulated in economic stability sustainment plan of the federal government of Nigeria. In the youth investment fund, dollar loan system fund, loan to pharmaceutical and agricultural-based manufacturing companies, all domiciled with the Central Bank of Nigeria. The 774 investment and training of entrepreneurs in all the local government of Nigeria. APC-led government of President Buhari is not paying lip service to people's oriented program. We are not mere rhetoric, as he has committed hundreds of billions of naira to this endeavor. Poverty elimination is one of the core objectives of the leader of our party, President Muhammadu Buhari, and he has gone about it with vigor and determination. It has not been easy, especially from where we are coming from. That is decades of misrule. The journey has been long and tough. The one thing no one will take away from the leader of our party in his sincerity and commitment to the cause of over 200 million Nigerians. So, as the ruling party in Nigeria, we hope to see greater collaboration between Nigeria and the Chinese government in enterprise development, especially in our infrastructure of power to energy generation, transmission, and distribution. Electricity is the characteristic infrastructure. It is the most essential infrastructure which benchmarks every other infrastructure in a country. Nigeria has a long and entangled journey in this trajectory. I don't want to go into this bad history. The 2009 power sector group, where billions of dollars were discovered, so have been wasted. But our leader, President Muhammadu Buhari, has done tremendous job thus far to change the negative. For instance, our government is currently lighting up over 5 million households, with over 20 million people benefiting from our decentralized solar energy solution. This is clean energy alternatives, which our country is committed to, as seen in the COP26 last UN Climate Change Conference. The Presidential Power Initiative was launched with potentials capable of reaching 25 gigawatts in a couple of years. The Manila Power Project is receiving attention after decades of neglect and holds the potential of ramming up Nigerian electric output by over 12%. Of course, some Chinese companies are involved, as well as the China Eastern Bank. This is positive for both countries. In conclusion, we are seeking for more development projects that will bring a better future for our people. China has the technology for off-grid solutions for power problems like solar, as well as the proficiency in pharmaceutical development, industrial and electrical appliances, which Nigeria benefited from, but at what cost? It is our conviction that our two ruling political parties need to go beyond mere political rift off and seek deeper collaboration for our people. There should be some form of program for technology transfer, exchange programs between the universities of our different countries for mutual benefits. There has to be transplantation of ideas and information if our relationship must be meaningful and go beyond one just leaning on the other. That is the true essence of strategic partnership. Thank you, Dr. Patrick. Let me thank you for the opportunity. I want to extend my regards on behalf of the National Chairman to you, Mr. Minister. And I bring you greetings from the National Chairman, His Excellency, Maronai Kalabu. Thank you for that.